Thank you. نعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا وسيئات اعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له واشهد ان نبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى اله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا اما بعد أن يحمد الله سبحانه وتعالى وأشكره على أن هيأ لنا هذه التوراة المباركة وأسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن ينفعنا بها جميعا. Once again, I welcome all of you. I hope that you are all well and your loved ones and your family members. I praise Allah سبحانه وتعالى once again for allowing us to get together here at Masjid Sunnah, alhamdulillah, amongst our families in the Chicago area. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all beneficial knowledge. Allahumma alimna ma yanfa'una wa anfa'na bima 'allamtana wa zidna Allahumma ilma. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us beneficial knowledge. We ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us and aid us to benefit from the knowledge. We ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase us in knowledge. Ameen. Inshallah, the main subject of this seminar is this book here that we're going to start reading from. Al-Irshadu ila Sahih al-I'tiqad wa raddi ala ahli shirki wal-ilhad. A guide to sound greed, sound faith, and greed of the Muslim that every Muslim should be upon, along with refutation against the people of shirk, the polytheists and the atheists. This book was authored by our noble Sheikh Al-Allamah Dr. Saleh bin Fawzan Al-Fawzan. حفظه الله تعالى ومتعه بالصحة والعافية وغفر له والوالدين ووالدينا والمسلمين والمسلمات أمين. كما لا يخفى عليكم فالموضوع ذو أهمية بالغة، موضوع العقيدة وتعلم العقيدة الإسلامية الصحيحة. When we hear this word عقيدة, the creed, sound creed, is one of the most important topics that every Muslim should take good care of. We should take good care of learning and understanding this topic. But alhamdulillah, we have material. We have abundance of books that teach the aqeedah, sahih, alhamdulillah, the creed of the Salaf, the creed and the belief of the Sahaba, the Tabi'een and Atba' al-Tabi'een. ذلك أن العقيدة الصحيحة هي الأساس الذي تبنى عليه جميع الأعمال صحة والفسادة. Because the sound creed is the foundation that all deeds, the rest of the deeds, built upon. If a person is not upon sound creed, not upon tawheed, but rather a person is upon shirk, no salat will be of any benefit. No fasting, no zakat, no aqeedah, no charity, no remembrance of Allah, recitation of the Quran will be of no benefit. But the person who has sound creed, alhamdulillah, will benefit from these actions. والدعوه الى العقيده وتصحيح العقيده والى الايمان بالله وحده سبحانه وتعالى واخلاص العباده له هذا من خصائص الانبياء والمرسلين هذه دعوته. And we all know that the da'wah of prophets and messengers, all of it is based on this, teaching the people tawheed, Islamic monotheism, correcting and rectifying the people's beliefs so that they worship none but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Here, share with you what our noble Shaykh al-Allama Abdul Aziz ibn Baz rahimahu Allah ta'ala says, قال فيجب وجوبا عظيما ومؤكدا أن يعتنى بالعقيدة. Shaykh Abdul Aziz ibn Baz, from the many great scholars who have great work that they have left for us about the Aqeedah and Tawheed. And I just chose to quote him. If you want to bring your quotes of the ulama about the importance of the Aqeedah, we would spend this seminar just doing that, that highlight the importance of this matter that we should attend with our hearts, not just with our bodies. We're here now, alhamdulillah, we're all here, but let's make efforts to stay here with our minds and our hearts, because that's how we're going to benefit. If we're just here by our bodies, but our minds somewhere else, we're not going to get the benefit. It's a very important topic. You have to take notes for those who can't take notes. Those who are not taking notes, it's okay, alhamdulillah. By attending, that's fi khair. Fi khair. But taking notes for those who are able, it helps. It helps a lot. يُحْفَظُ الْعِلْمُ بِالْكِتَابَةِ. Even if you have a good memory, even if you have a sound memory, alhamdulillah, when you write, you can go back to what you've written, can share it with other people. But being here, even though you're not taking notes, فِي خَيْرْ عَظِيمٌ. It's a lot of good, a lot of خَيْرْ, inshallah. Try to get the book too, and these are the tools that help to get the book. Why people, they benefit in academics, whether they study history, physics, science, IT. They attend the classes regularly. There is a curriculum. They take notes. They have homework. They do tests. So we try to do that, inshallah, to the best of your ability. Get the book. Read with your family. Share the notes if you took any notes. If you didn't take notes, mashallah, you have good memory, you go home, write them down. But now you remember, tomorrow, after tomorrow, you may forget. Write it down in a book. Have a notebook just for this class. And write benefits, inshallah ta'ala. Memorize also if you can. Barakallahu feekum. Shaykh Abdul Aziz ibn Baz, rahimahu ta'ala, says it is very important. It's a great importance that as Muslims we should take good care of the aqeedah. Should take good care of the creed, the sound creed. وَلِيَعْتَنِي الْعُلَمَاءُ فِي إِيضَاحِ عَلِ النَّاسِ مِنْ عَامَةٍ وَخَاصَةٍ. So that especially the scholars, they should make efforts and be diligent in disseminating the عَقِيدَ الصَّحِيحَ to the people, the general people, students. Everybody needs the عقيدة. وأن تكون الدروس غالبا تعتني بها مع العناية كذلك بالأخلاق والأحكام الأخرى. Says the classes, especially in the masajid or in any schools and institutes or institutions, they're supposed to make sure that one of the main important subjects is the عقيدة, is the creed. Tawheed, Islamic monotheism. People, they need to know the Iman, the sound creed and sound belief. Along with that, the Shaykh said, people need to be taught the akhlaq as well. Should learn the great akhlaq of Islam, so that we can adorn ourselves with the good manners and akhlaq of Islam, along with ahkam, rulings and regulations. Na'am, focus on the aqidah, the tawheed, and warning against its opposite, the shirk. This sound creed has to be made clear to the people. Some people are confused. They are upon shirk and they think they are upon something good. Because in their areas, people are not teaching them the proper aqidah, the sound creed, the creed of the salaf. But in the same with that, people, they need to learn how to tahara. Should be classes of fiqh as well, so that the people, they learn how to worship Allah correctly, how to make wudu correctly, how to make ghusl correctly, how to make tayammum, the rulings of the mas'h al-khafain. They need to learn how to pray correctly, as the Prophet ﷺ prayed. They need to learn how to pray janazah. They need to learn the ahkam of zakat, fasting, hajj, umrah, along buying, selling, trades, marrying, this, how to deal with one another. It's very important. لكن مع هذا تكون العناية الكبرى بالعقيدة. نعم, people, they need to learn the mu'amalat, the akhlaq, the ahkam, the rulings, regulations, the seerah of the Prophet ﷺ, the Arabic language, the tafsir, the hadith. But this is the most important, the aqidah, the creed. Alhamdulillah, jazakumullah khair, and the ikhwa, that they want to study this book. Actually, we were studying this book with the brothers here in Chicago on online. We went to maybe class number 6, something like that. But they asked, they said, it would be better if we start the book all over again. That would be khair, inshallah ta'ala. So we're going to start from the beginning, inshallah ta'ala. I see that some of you have the book in English. I may use it, inshallah ta'ala, for some passages, especially for translations from the ayats and the hadith, bi'idhnillahi ta'ala. So therefore, I'm going to read the Arabic text and go ahead and translate as I go. So my translation, it might not go hand to hand with what's in the book. All right, so alhamdulillah. But you can follow me in Allah ta'ala. Waffaqan Allah wa iyyakum. We ask Allah to grant us all tawfiq. So may Allah open our hearts and our minds so that we can understand this great matter and this great subject, which is, as we mentioned, and the ulama, they mentioned, of great importance. Al-Muqaddima, this book, we're just going to go straight to read the book. The brief biography of Sheikh Fawzan, we mentioned it many times, alhamdulillah, and it's available online. You do homework, and you want to know a little bit more about the Sheikh Salih al-Fawzan, Hafidhullah Ta'ala, one of the contemporary scholars, who's still alive, may Allah give him a good life, good health, and preserve him for us, and allow us to continue to benefit from his work. But inshallah ta'ala, what you can do is read his biography. It's found in some of the books, alhamdulillah, in English, or it's found in some of his books, alhamdulillah. قال الشيخ الحمد لله رب العالمين خلقنا لعبادته وأمرنا بتوحيده وطاعته وهو غني عنا ونحن المحتاجون. He began by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sometimes the ulama, they don't mention the well-known and the classic khutbat al-hajah that is well-known to us. إِنَّ الْحَمْدَ لِلَّهِ نَحْمَدُهُ وَنَسْتَعِينُهُ وَنَسْتَغْفِرُهُ. But sometimes the mashayikh, they began by another, يعني مقدمة, like this one. The shaykh says, praise be to Allah, Lord of the world, who has created us to worship Him and ordered us to believe in His oneness and obey His commands. Though He is not in need of our help, whereas we need His help. So this means, Ya Quran, that whatever good we do, we benefit ourselves. Allah ghaniyun anna. Allah stands in no need for our righteousness. If everybody is righteous, that's not going to add anything to Allah's kingdom and dominion. And if everybody is corrupted and wicked, it's not going to affect Allah's kingdom in any way. So when we do good, it's only for our benefit, for ourselves. قال الله تعالى وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون ما أريد منهم من رزق وما أريد أن يطعمون إن الله هو القوة هو الرزاق ذو القوة المتين. سورة الذاريات. سورة الذاريات is famous ayat that are mentioned always in these subjects of ibadah, of tawheed. Translation of these verses 56 through 58. And I did not create the jinn and mankind except to worship me. The ulama, they mentioned from Ibn Abbas and others, they says to worship me by tawheed. ليعبدون أي ليوحدون. As Imam Muhammad Abdul Wahhab رحمه الله تعالى says, لأن العبادة لا تسمى عبادة إلا مع التوحيد. كما أن الصلاة لا تسمى صلاة إلا مع الطهارة. As Imam Sheikh Islam Mujaddid Muhammad Abdul Wahhab رحمه الله تعالى, he says in one of his books, maybe the Qawaid al-Arba, he says you should know that worship is not considered worship. Not going to be of any benefit without tawheed. Without that person who's praying, fasting, giving zakat, being upon tawheed, Islamic qualities. So the same way, salat will be of no benefit and not valid if a person pray without wudu. You see? So now you see a person pray next to you, right behind the imam. Of course, everybody, when he's asked, is so-and-so prayed? Yes, he prayed. But if he prayed without wudu, did he pray? Did he pray? He did not pray. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, in hadith al-sahih, wa fi abdat al-ahkam, wa fi sahihain, inna Allah la yaqbalu salata ahadikum, idha ahdatha, hatta yatawadda. This is one of the first ahadith in Abd al-Ahkam, in Kitab al-Tahara. Verily Allah does not accept the salat of one of you when he breaks his tahara until that person purify himself. Likewise, Allah does not accept the deeds, salat, fasting, hajj, zakat, without tawheed. So Allah says, I did not create the jinn and mankind except to worship me. I do not want from them any provision, nor do I want them to feed me. Indeed, it is Allah who is the continual provider for His creatures, the firm possessor of strength. قال أرسل رسوله داعية إلى التوحيد وإخلاص الدين كما قال تعالى في سورة الأنبياء وما أرسلنا من قبلك من رسول إلا نوحي إليه أنه لا إله إلا أنا فاعبدون. Sheikh says, Sheikh Sahan Rozan, is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the exalted, sent all his messengers, all of them, to call people to worship Allah alone and be devout in serving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, making every single act of worship for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you understand that this is the da'wah of all prophets and messengers. All of them call to tawheed. None of them call to any other than that. So now the Christian, they say that now Jesus said his Lord is, that's not true. Every single prophet and messenger called the people to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah tells us in Surah Al-Anbiya, verse number 25, and we sent not before you, the address to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, any messenger, except that we revealed to him that there is no deity worthy of worship. So here he said, there is no deity except me. But he can add, there is no deity worthy of worship. Okay? We can add that there. That there is no deity that deserves to be worshipped. There is no God that deserves to be worshipped except Allah. So worship me by devoting all acts of worship for him. قال الشيخ: وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ولو كره المشركون. He said, I testify that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who is the one that has no partners, even if the polytheists hate that? وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم من الناس أجمعين. He says, I testify that Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is Allah's servant and messenger sent to all people. صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه الذين هاجروا وجاهدوا وصبروا والذين آووا أصحابه الذين هاجروا وجاهدوا وصبروا يعني المهاجرين الذين هاجروا من مكة للمدينة والذين آووا ونصروا يعني الأنصار الأنصار من المدينة وسلم تسليما كثيرا إلى يوم الدين. And the Shaykh says, may Allah's peace and blessings be upon the Prophet, his household, and his companions who may grade it, strive in Allah's cause, and keep patient upon that, upon the difficulties that they faced from that time. This is pertaining to the Muhajireen. The Muhajireen, that the companions of Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ali, and the rest of the companions who made the Hijrah, migrated from Mecca to Al-Madinah with the Prophet ﷺ. Some of them, they migrated to Al-Habasha first, Al-Hijratain. Some of the companions in the early years of Islam, Allah, the Prophet ﷺ allowed them to go to Al-Habasha, Abyssinia, Ethiopia in our times, that area. Al-Habasha. And then after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him permission to his Prophet and the believers to make the hijrah, to migrate from Mecca to Al-Madinah, and they were supported by the Ansar, the helpers. The Ansar, Wal-Aws, Wal-Hazraj, mainly from these two tribes and other tribes of Al-Madinah, which used to be called Yathrib at that time. Amma ba'du. As to follow, the Shaykh says, فَلَمَّا كَانَ تَوْضِيحُ الْعَقِيدَةِ الصَّحِيحَةِ وَالدَّعْوَةُ إِلَيْهَا هُوَ أَهَمُّ الْأُمُورِ وَآكَدُ الْوَاجِبَاتِ. He says, you can understand one thing here. This is, by the way, this is an introduction. It's a beautiful introduction. It contains great benefits, alhamdulillah, that we're supposed to go back to it and read it over and over and over, so that what's in it can be installed in our minds, in our hearts, so that we can act upon that. And we know that this subject matter is one of the most important subject matters. Any Muslim should learn this aqidah. No one is exempt. No one can say, it's okay. No, it's not. Yeah, you can say it's okay if you don't want to learn yani usul al-fiqh. He says, it's okay, other people are learning, alhamdulillah, I'm okay with me. It's okay. But you cannot say, it's not okay. It's okay to not to learn aqidah. No, that's a big mistake. So it's very important. He says, making or clarifying the sound creed and calling to it. Not only does clarifying it, but we'll make sure that the Muslims, they get the information. Everyone according to his level, ikhwan. Like in the Muslim countries, this is upon the governments to make sure that the Muslims are being taught. The governments, they're supposed to make sure that the aqidah sahiha, al-aqidah salafiyya sahiha al-naqiyya, the creed of the salaf, that was the Prophet ﷺ left the companions upon, should be taught in the schools, in universities. As alhamdulillah, in some of the countries, it's happening, like in Saudi Arabia. If you look at the curriculums from the first grade until master's or whatever, PhD, they teach them the aqidah sahiha, the sound creed, alhamdulillah.
These books that we study here, Tilawat al-Rasul, Kitab al-Tawheed, and Qawaid al-Arba, they are taught in these schools. Jazakumullah khair. Likewise, in the smaller scale, like the masajid. Masajid, the imams, the students of knowledge, they're supposed to focus on clarifying the sound creed. Now, this is what is right, this is what is wrong. This is what the Sahaba were upon, we follow it, this is khair. The Sahaba were not upon these things. Actually, this is something that was introduced by some deviant people a couple hundreds of years after the Sahaba. And we should not be on that. It is la khayra fi, it is no good in it. That's what the Shaykh is intended by this. To clarify the sound creed and call to it. We call ourselves to it. We parents, we call our children, because we are responsible of our children, to our children. Allah Ta'ala, ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, qu anfusakum wa ahlikum nara. O you who believe, protect yourselves and your families from a fire. How are you going to protect them? As the ulama, Ibn Abbas, Ali radiallahu anhu and others, they says, علموهم الدين وأدبوهم بالآداب الإسلامية الرفيعة. Teach them the religion, starting by the most important thing. Teach them the aqidah, teach them tawheed, teach them sunnah, teach them how to love Allah, to love the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and teach them the good akhlaq of Islam. لماذا العقيدة هي من أكد الواجبات؟ لأنها الأساس الذي تبنى عليه صحة الأعمال وقبولها. The Sheikh says why it is so important for us to focus on learning the عقيدة. Every one of us should participate according to their means to disseminate the عقيدة, even on the individual level. You're not an imam of a masjid. You're not responsible of any city. You're not a mudir in an institution or a university. Then you can share. Like this book, you buy a copy or two and give it out. Allahu Akbar. You learn this book, alhamdulillah. You get al-irshad ila sa'il al-i'tiqad, Sheikh Fawzan. You get it, alhamdulillah. It's easy to get books these days. You can get them from Amazon, man. Amazon, they sell books of Aqidah, alhamdulillah. They're in the money, you know. So, but it's easy, I'm saying. The point I'm making, it's easy these days to get books. Get book one for you and get few if you have the money. Get a few extra and give them out as a gift. لَنْ يَهْدِيَ اللَّهُ بِكَمْ رِعًا وَاحِدًا. If Allah guide one person to the sound creed because of your effort, that's better for you than the money of this dunya here. And especially in our times, reality is, which is sad reality, that many of us that Allah has guided us to the sound creed, we still have family members that are struggling with Sophia, with Shirk, with that. What are we doing to try to help them? You cannot just say, oh, they choose that path, let it be. No, it's not. You should do something about it. You have a father, you have a mother, you have aunties, you have cousins. Sometimes you may be the only one upon this sound creed. Your entire family, immediate family, far family, cousins, aunties, uncles, they're Muslims. But some of them, they are upon shirk. You have to follow the methodology of the prophets in calling to Allah. Ibrahim alayhi salam, he dealt with his father for years. He was nice. Ya abati. He used to address him in the best way. So you address your parents, your grandparents, your aunties, your cousins, your uncles who are struggling. Because people, they just grow up in an environment. That's all they know. They grow up in a Sufi environment. They grow up in a corrupt environment. And then those so-called mashayikh and big famous ones, they respect them. It's normal, of course. They respect their scholar, they respect the imam of the masjid. So that's why when you come and talk to them, they're like, look, we have our scholars. We have our shaykh. That's why it's important. They don't tell them, this is what I'm telling you. Tell them, qala Allah, qala Rasulullah. That's all. Because when you tell them قال الله بالدليل, they're not going to tell you, I don't want to hear that. They may tell you something here, they may tell you, oh, listen, we don't understand Quran, we understand it through the Messiah. You tell them, look, this ayah here, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. This ayah is clear. As the ulama mentioned, the most clear verses in the Quran that they don't even need explanation are the ayahs, the verses of Tawheed. The ayahs of Tawheed. It's so clear. وَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ. Worship Allah alone. This is clear. وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا. And do not associate with him anything or anyone in worship. Very clear. Now, my friend, it's very important to be kind, gentle, easy, choose the right things, right time, right expression to address your people, to address the people who are suffering from bid'ah, innovations, and other than that, some shirk. And hidayah is only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't do that and think like after a couple of months they have to be upon da'wah salafiyah. You can't guide people. Allah does subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hidayah to tawfiq wal ilham. As the ulama, they mentioned the hidayah is two types. Two types of hidayah. Hidayah to irshad, wal bayan, wal idah. That's, you can do it. You can do it personally if you are able, if you have knowledge, you have understanding, you have hikmah, you have patience, you have leniency, you have kindness, you have mercy. But if you don't have none of this, let a book do the talk for you. Just give a book as a gift. As for the second type of hidayah, hidayah to tawfiq, who's going to accept the truth and who's not? That's only for Allah, Rabbul Alamin. It's not even for the prophets and the messengers. The Sheikh says this is so important because the sound creed is the foundation that all of the deeds are built upon. For the deeds to be sound and accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they have to be built upon the sound creed. It's not enough to just pray and fast and read Quran and a person is upon shirk. But the shirk nullify all the deeds. That's why it's so important. You see, the ulama from the Sunnah of Jama'ah, they compile books of Aqeedah, they teach it, seminars on Aqeedah, because of this very important. If the foundation is shut down, what are you going to build? Huh? If you want to go and buy a house and you bring in experts, see, if you don't bring in experts, the expert goes straight to where? To the foundation. A non-expert, where he's going to go to? Kitchen. A beautiful kitchen. Oh yeah, we can do a lot of cookouts in here. Oh, look at big yard. Oh, look at the third floor. SubhanAllah, this beautiful jacuzzi. Jacuzzi is going to go down because the foundation shut down. So the expert is in the basement. Huh? The people who don't know, they're upstairs looking in the view. A view that will go away soon. And then the expert would come and say, no, it's not good. No, let this go, man. Good for you. Then the other people don't know, oh my God, man, look at these closets. Look at this big kitchen. Look at this. But that stuff is standing on what? On something that is about to go down. Likewise. People all look how he recites. Look at the du'a, look at their fastings, but if no aqidah, is nothing. That's why it's important to take good care of aqidah. وَلِهَذَا كَانَ اهْتِمَامُ الرُّسُلِ صَلَوَاتُ اللَّهِ وَسَلَامُهُ عَلَيْهِمْ وَاهْتِمَامُ أَتْبَاعِهِمْ بِإِصْلَاحِ الْعَقِيدَةِ أَوَّلًا عَمَّا يُنَاقِدُهَا أَوْ يُنْقِسُهَا. So because of this, because of the importance of this subject matter, you will find that the messengers, all messengers of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam, and their followers, at least every follower of every messenger, and like in our time, the Prophet, the companions, And their followers were keen on purifying their greed from all that which contradicts it or contaminates it. Because there are certain things that actually nullify the aqeedah. Person is not an Islam. When the people they are punished, when the people they fall into one of the nullifiers of Islam. Even though the person he still have a Muslim name, he still name Abdullah, Abdurrahman, Muhammad. She still have Aisha name, Hafsa, Khadija, Fatima. They still pray in the masjid, Jumu'ah, they read Quran, they fast, maybe they make Hajj. But if they are upon shirk, that nullifies their deeds. And once again, what the people say about them is not going to be a benefit for them. No, 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 he's always here. Yeah, but that person is upon shirk, that's a big problem. That's why you find these great scholars, the followers of the prophets, the inheritors of the prophets, they take good care of the aqeedah. وكان نصيب هذا الجانب من سور القرآن وآياته النصيب الأوفر. Likewise, that's why you find when you examine and reflect, when you read the book of Allah, when you read the book of Allah, you see in the chapters great ayats, many verses that deal with this matter and make clear for us this very important matter, which is al-aqeedah, the sound creed. وَكَانَ كَذَلِكَ نَصِيبُهُمْ مِنْ دَعْوَةِ الرَّسُولِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ وَاهْتِمَامُهُ النَّصِيبُ الْأَكْبَرِ. When you look at the da'wah and the call of our noble Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, you see that he focused as well on this matter of aqeedah. From the first day of his da'wah until before he died, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, aqeedah, tawheed. Calling to tawheed, warning against shirk. Calling to tawheed, warning against shirk. Making sure that the people will be upon some creed. فَقَدْ مَكَّةَ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ فِي مَكَّةَ 13 سَنَةً يَدْعُوا إِلَى التَّوْحِيدِ وَإِصْلَاحِ الْعَقِيدَةِ. We all know this when you read the biography of the Prophet ﷺ, the seerah of the Prophet ﷺ. The Prophet ﷺ spent his first 13 years of da'wah in Mecca, according to Tawheed. Many of the rules and regulations, halal, haram, fasting, hajj, jihad, that was revealed in Medina. But in Mecca, the most important subject matter is the Tawheed, is clarifying the creed, so that the people be upon Tawheed. Because you cannot mix Tawheed and shirk. Just can't. You can't worship Allah and devote other acts of worship to other than Allah. That's what the mushrikeen of Quraysh used to do. They believed in Allah. You think the mushrikeen of Quraysh said there is no Allah? No, they believed in Allah. They used to call upon Allah, especially in the times of difficulty. When they are in a war, they call upon Allah wahdahu. Da'awu Allah wahdahu. They call upon Allah sincerely, making the ibadah sincerely, purely for Him. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved them to, and they saved, then they turn to riyad billah, into associating and ascribing partners with Him in worship. ولما فتح الله عليه مكة كان الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم أول ما بدأ به هدم الأصنام والقضاء عليها. Look also what highlight the importance of this matter. When the Prophet ﷺ, when Allah granted the Messenger of Allah ﷺ victory and enabled him to conquer Mecca, and Mecca became land of Islam, because Mecca was land of shirk. In the time when the Prophet ﷺ started calling to Tawheed, the people of Mecca, many of them, the heads, the leaders, they were mushrikun. And they were fighting, they fought the Prophet ﷺ, they fought the Tawheed, they fought this Aqeedah. Prophet ﷺ, he made Hijrah to Al-Madina. And 8 or 9 years later, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant victory to the Prophet ﷺ, And Mecca became the land of Islam and Tawheed, alhamdulillah. So what's the problem? First thing the Prophet ﷺ did, he destroyed all the idols. Many idols that were inside, outside, pictures of their idols. Prophet ﷺ stopped by destroying all the idols which had been worshipped by those people. That was the first thing he did, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then he instructed people to be sincere in worshipping Allah, the one who has no partners. Why? Because as we mentioned to you, the pagans of Quraysh, they used to dedicate acts of worship for Allah. They believed in Allah. But their problem, they used to worship others beside Allah. That's why they say, أَجَعَلَ الْآلِهَةَ إِلَهًا وَاحِدًا. They say, this man, Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, wants to make all of the gods into one god. See, that's why they refuse to say La ilaha illallah. You think they refuse to say La ilaha illallah because they couldn't say it? They were Arabs, man. These people, they were masters of the Arabic language. They didn't need to take courses of Arabic or language or grammar or herself. In their time, there were no dots. See, these dots we have in here, and tashkil, they even have it, they don't need it. Or try to take all the dots from this paragraph and try to read it. They didn't need these things. Later on, people needed books of Nahu, books of Arabic, because people are, that's it, the Arabic was not very important to certain people, which is, unfortunately, should be. This is the language of Quran, the language of this beautiful religion of Islam. Now, so the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he called the people to purify their ibadah, not worship Allah and worship others with Allah. No, Allah alone. If you say you believe in Allah, you have to give up all other idols, all other false deities. You deny them, and you worship only Allah alone. The pagan of Quraysh, they didn't want to do that. Because when he said to them, say La ilaha illallah, they understood the meaning of La ilaha illallah, that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah. Meaning what? Forget about everybody else. Worship Allah alone, that's something they want to do. The ulama, they mentioned, from the Sheikh Ibn Baz, Sheikh Al-Albani and others, said in our times, there are people who are on shirk. They live in the Muslim countries. They pray with the Muslims, but they don't understand La ilaha illallah. They say La ilaha illallah in the adhan, in the tashahud, but the same time they say Ya Jailani, Ya Badawi, Ya Marghani, Ya Tijani, Ya Baba Farid, Ya Bamba, Ya Kada, Ya Ali, Ya Hussein. Yeah, even if you cannot call upon anybody besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they don't understand. The pagan of Quraysh, they have better understanding of La ilaha illallah than many of these people. Now, قال الشيخ وقد أولى علماء هذه الأمة هذا الجانب قدرا كبيرا من جهودهم وجهادهم وتعليمهم وتأليفهم حتى شغلت كتب العقيدة حيزا كبيرا من المكتبة الإسلامية وصار لها الصدارة بين محتوياتها. He says, many of the scholars, alhamdulillah, of this ummah, this is subhanAllah, we have great treasures about Aqeedah and the books of Aqeedah. It says, many great scholars of this ummah, they gave a great importance to this matter, the Aqeedah. And this is something that is well known in their efforts, their striving, their teachings, dear books that they compile. So much so that when you look at the Maktab al-Islamiyya, the Muslim library, when you look at the books, meaning when it comes to these books of Aqeedah, books of Tawheed, Fiqh, books of Hadith, books of Tafsir, books of this and that, you'll find that the books of Aqeedah, they have a great, percentage in the Maktab al-Islamiyya. And this is because of the importance of this matter, because something that is more important, you have to take good care of. We know that, we, as a human being, if you work and you have to pay rent, right? And especially the rent, if it's like $2,000, usually that's the most important thing you have to take care of, rare of. That's why in your paycheck, you know that the big chunk of the paycheck gonna go to the rent. You don't neglect that. And just keep like spending the money, and then when the landlord comes, but I don't have it. No, I mean, you be in the street with your families. You know the consequences of that. Likewise, the Aqeedah, Ikhwan, is very important. We need to find time to learn the Aqeedah. It is not an option, learn the Aqeedah or not. When you hear a seminar about the Aqeedah, when you need that, alhamdulillah, this is not just any seminar that we're going to come and talk about general lectures, which is there is khair in them, like Sheikh Ubaid, alhamdulillah, ta'ala. He mentioned more than once, and the ulama of Ahlul Islam, they said that by Sheikh Ubaid advised us years ago, over 20 years ago. He says, yeah, Abnai, because when we used to call him for a talk, till a length, and they said, the Sheikh is like, what is it about, the topic? He said, give us a lecture, your Sheikh, on the importance of Aqeedah Tawheed. And then the Sheikh said, I will do so, but the right and proper way is that you study a book. He says, now lecture, general lecture about Aqeedah, for example, it's good. There is khair in it, no doubt. There is khair in it. But you're not going to get all the details, all the benefits in 1 hour lecture. This book you're going to study for, if we continue on these 3 days, a month, if I come, Allah allow me to come here once a month, when you do the math, we'll see how long we. It's going to take us maybe a year to 6 months, a year to finish this. Because he has details, alhamdulillah, as you're going to see details. So when you hear something about Allah, mashallah, Iman, Billah, Wahdaniyat Allah, Tawheed al-Rububiyyah, Tawheed al-. It's just not like a name that you know. No, you have details. لأن دعوة أهل السنة والجماعة دعوة تفصيلية. Because the دعوة of أهل السنة والجماعة is based on details. The other people, they just give you like a general part, general statements. How you, what is the details? That's okay, you don't need the details now. No, you need the details. And that's how these books, alhamdulillah, of أهل السنة والجماعة. The Sheikh said, وقد أحببت أن أسهم بجهدي القليل في هذا العمل الجليل. And then the Sheikh says, I said, with this I mind, and I tried to contribute with my humble effort to this great area. This is a modesty from the Sheikh. This is how modest, and we learn from the ulama. We learn from them. He says, he wants to, this is just like a humble effort for him to contribute in disseminating the sound creed and the sound aqeedah. This is the time for the adhan, time for the iqamah. I mean, He says, writing this book hardly adds any new information. Look how modest the Shaykh. SubhanAllah. قَدْ فَكَتَبْتُ هَذِهِ الْكَلِمَاتِ الَّتِي أُقَدِّمُهَا لِلْقَارِئِ وَهِيَ لَمْ تَأْتِي بِشَيْءٍ جَدِيدٍ وإنما هي تقريب لبعض المعلومات وقد يكون فيها ربط لواقع الناس اليوم وممارساتهم بتلك المعلومات حتى يتضح حكمها ويتبين خطأ أصحاب تلك الممارسات لعلهم يرجعون وكذلك هو نصيحة لغيرهم لعلهم يحذرون. The Sheikh says, writing this book hardly adds any new information, but rather it clarifies some information, makes a connection between people's practices and the Muslim creed, and points out to what extent people abide by the principles of the Muslim creed, so as to judge those practices and explain the wrong acts they may contain, so that people may abstain from doing them. Furthermore, this book offers advice to people so that they may Prescott. And the Sheikh is saying here that this is a great book, alhamdulillah, for us to understand. Not only for us, but also to be, to serve, to guide those people who are misguided. Because you think everybody who opposed the Aqidah of Ahlul Sunnah or Jama'ah, the sound creed, because he wants to be on the right, the wrong side? He wants to go to the hellfire? No. These are people, and these people we're talking about, some of them are our family members. Our cousins, our aunties, our uncles, our grandparents, sometimes our parents. That's who they grow up upon. They grow up learning what these people in their environments, they taught them. Even if it's wrong, even if it has deadly consequences. But now, alhamdulillah, open our hearts and our eyes. Alhamdulillah, we know that the Aqidah is to be taken from its proper sources, the Book of Allah, the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah, with the understanding of Salaf al-Saleh. Aqidah is not just something that you inherit, something that you pick up from your tribe. And you pick up things from your tribe, the language, for example. If you grow up in Pakistan, you're not going to speak Swahili, man. Are you? You speak Swahili? You? You don't. You grow up in India, you're not going to speak Chinese. Try to take some pizza to some village in India right now, or Pakistan. Huh? What are they going to say to you? What are they going to say, Mark? Say, what is this? He said, food. He said, that's not food. You don't know. So now we pick up some things from our people. The language, the food, some habits, some customs. But then when we come to the Aqidah, you don't say, no, listen, I'm just going to stick to what my people is upon. No, you should to stick to what the Prophet was upon his companions. But how are you going to explain this to them? Well, grant us tawfiq. It needs a whole life. But what's the most important thing? That we should learn first. We should learn first, alhamdulillah. Now. So the Sheikh says, وَقَدْ اِقْتَبَسْتُ هَذِهِ الْكَلِمَاتِ مِنْ كُتُبِ أَئِمَّةِ الدِّينِ وَعُلَمَاءِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ كَكُتُبِ شَيْخِ الْإِسْلَامِ ابْنِ تَيْمِيَّةَ وَتِلْمِيذِهِ ابْنِ الْقَيِّمِ وَتِلْمِيذِهِ الْحَافِظِ ابْنِ كَثِيرٍ وَمِنْ كُتُبِ شَيْخِ الْإِسْلَامِ مُحَمَّدِ عَبْدِ الْوَهَّابِ وَتِلْمِيذِهِ أَئِمَّةِ الدَّعْوَةِ الْإِصْلَاحِيَّةِ خصوصا كتاب فتح المجيد. Look how humble this mashayikh, and we should learn from their modesty. He says, I have quoted in this book the writings of the great imams and eminent Muslim scholars like Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, Ibn al-Qayyim, Ibn al-Kathir, and Shaykh Muhammad ibn al-Wahhab, and his students who were the imams of the Reformation call, meaning those who in their time was a lot of bid'ah, shirk. When you hear Reformation, they call to Tawheed. They see shirk was spread, and they call to Tawheed and warn against shirk. They see that the Sunnah has been neglected by many people, not even known by many people. Rather, the innovations are spread, they call the people to Sunnah and warn them against innovations. Now, is among the books I have quoted from is the book entitled Fathul Majid. This is by Sheikh, the Kitab al-Fath al-Majid is the explanation of Kitab al-Tawheed. Okay? Fath al-Majid is said by Sheikh Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab. Actually, this is a book by one of the grandsons of Sheikh Muhammad ibn Wahhab. It's an explanation of Kitab al-Tawheed, Fath al-Majid. قال ولا أدعي أنني أتيت بجديد وإنما أرجو أن أكون قربت بعض المعلومات وربطتها بواقع الناس كلما سنحت فرصة وعرضت مناسبة. Look how humble the Mashayikh. He said, I feel inclined to say that what I have written is not something that is new. But I hope that I have clarified some information and related it to the daily practices of people whenever there is a chance to do so. قال واصل هذا الكتاب كان حلقات أذيعت من إذاعة القرآن الكريم في المملكة العربية السعودية وما كان في نيتي أن تخرج في كتاب لولا تقدير الله سبحانه. ثم إن بعض الإخوة الكرام اقترح علي جمعها وتنسيقها وإخراجها في كتابي، فنفعل إن شاء الله، وأرجو أن يكون بذلك الخير وأن تكون إسهاما وتضعيلا في مجال الدعوة إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى في وقت جهلت فيه طريقة الدعوة الصحيحة، وصار كثير من الدعاة يهتمون بجوانب ضئيلة لا تسمن ولا تغني من جوع بدون العقيدة، ويتركون جانب العقيدة وهم يرون الناس متورطين في الشرك الأكبر حول الأضرحة والمزارات ومتورطين في البدع والخرافات، ويرون دعاة الضلال قد استحوذوا على كثير من الجهلة والعوام وساقوهم إلى مواقع الهلاك والضلال واتخذوهم عبيدا لهم، يتصرفون بعقولهم وأموالهم ويترأسون عليهم بالباطل باسم العلم والولاية. سبحان الله. Beautiful statement. I had to read all of it because I cannot just chop it. It's going to mess with the meaning. That's why we're going to read the English translation, all of it as well. The Sheikh said this book here, Irhamukallah, said this book, Al-Irshad ila Sahih al-Atiqad, this book is compiled from a series, he says, which they have presented on the Noble Quran broadcast station in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. As I know from the Ni'am in Saudi Arabia, they have a program in the radio station. You know, unlike in other places, especially in the West, they have many radio stations that talk about politics and all of whatever. In there, they have radio stations where the ulama give fatawa, give classes. Like Noor al-Darb, this is a famous radio broadcast. Noor al-Darb. We have so many books from Noor al-Darb, the fatawa of Sheikh bin Baz, fatawa of Sheikh al-Uthaymeen. They came from that. So that's this book was actually the result of these classes that the Sheikh was gave alive. He would give a live class on Aqidah on the radio station. See how beautiful that you turn the radio station, you go to work, you turn your radio station, and you don't hear Rayhana and Beyonce. You hear Kitab al-Tawheed. Huh? You don't hear jazz. Huh? You hear Kitab al-Tawheed. Alim al-Ulama, Ahl al-Sunnah al-Jama'ah is teaching Kitab al-Tawheed, Talatat al-Rusul, Allahu Akbar. Another one is teaching the book of Fiqh, Arabic, Tafsir, Sira, Ni'mah ya akhi, wallahi, Ni'mah wallahi. He said, at that time, he says, when he was giving these talks on the radio broadcast, he said, I did not have the intention to introduce such episodes in the form of a book until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills. Some brothers, he says, urged me to compile, edit, and classify these episodes and then publish them in the form of a book so that many people may benefit from them over time if Allah so will. And we are from these people. Here we are in America, alhamdulillah, we benefit from this work. Allah, my Allah, great the Sheikh, I mean, grant him a great reward. Then the Sheikh says, I hope that such work may be a good contribution in the field of da'wah, according to Allah, glorified be He. He says, for now we are living in a time when many people are ignorant of the method of sound da'wah. That's true. Anybody call to Allah, anybody, masajid, anybody can open a masjid, anybody can call. In addition, in our time, you know, people, anybody can open a chat room right now, a website and call it, I don't know what, and start teaching the people. If he's eloquent and there, he has so many followers, and all of a sudden he became Sheikh al-Islam, Allahu Musta'an. In addition, he says, many of the Muslim preachers show great interest in small aspects that avail nothing without clarifying the sound Muslim creed. In principle, they leave out the aspect of doctrine, despite the fact that many people are, to great extent, involved in major shirk, which is a reality in some Muslim countries. In polytheism, through seeking the help of dead righteous people, those who call upon the Prophet ﷺ, they call upon angels, they call upon Ali, Hussein, Jailani, and glorifying their graves, while many others are enslaved by the innovation and superstitions. Sad reality upon until our times. Said, moreover, it is observed that those calling to aberrations have controlled the minds of the lay people, the common folks, and the ignorant ones, and driven them to do what destroys them and leads them astray. Al-awam li man sabaq, as Shaykh Ubayd rahimahullah used to say, he says, Al-awam li man sabaq, the laymen and the common folks, they're going to follow the first one who gets to them. If a alim, student of knowledge of Sunnah, Tawheed, get to them and introduce to them, they will, alhamdulillah, learn the Sunnah. But if a Hizbi, a Mubtadi, a Mushrik even, get to them first, they will follow him. Oh, this is Shaykh. Because then they respect the position. He says, the common folks are deceived by those calling to deviations, who have controlled their minds and properties, and baselessly made themselves leaders in the name of being knowledgeable and devoted to Allah. Do they talk about that? See, the ulama of Islam, when they are praised, they're like, they don't want to do praises. How many times you heard Sheikh bin Baz stop somebody? He's like, well, we have this great alim for you. That's enough. That's enough. Read the book. Read the book. People are coming here to benefit. Other people of Ahlul Bidah and Hizbiyah, if he's not praised, he's not coming back. Some of them, he comes, he's like, that's all? 70 people, that's it? No, I'm out of here. You got to go get more people. The ulama of Ahlul Sunnah al Jama'ah, they used to run from crowds. Some of the Salaf, they said, if three people sit, he's gone. SubhanAllah. قال الشيخ إن كثيرا من الدعاة اليوم مع الأسف لا يهتمون بجانب العقيدة وإصلاحها بل ربما يقول بعضهم اتركوا الناس على عقائدهم ولا تتعرضوا لها اجمعوا ولا تفرقوا مثل دعوة الإخوان المسلمين لنجتمع على ما اتفقنا عليه وليعذر بعضنا بعضا فيما اختلفنا فيه أو نحو من هذه العبارات التي تخالف كلام الله في سورة النساء فإن تنازعتم في شيء فردوه إلى الله والرسول إن كنتم تؤمنون بالله واليوم الآخر ذلك خير وأحسن تأويلا. Now the Shaykh is going to refute some of the deviant sects, mainly the Ikhwan Muslimin, and whoever speak without knowledge. Is unfortunately many of the callers to Islam, they say they callers to Islam, do not take interest in illustrating the aspects of creed and rectifying the people's wrong practices in this regard. They don't care about that. They don't care about the aqidah. He says some of those people may say that it is better to leave people adopt the doctrines they have so as not to make dispersion and differentiation and division among the people. They say that. They said, now if you start teaching Tawheed, Aqidah, you're going to divide the people. Just let's gather the people. This is some of them even say, this is this saying of Al-Ikhwan. They say, let us together in adopting, let's stay and help one another, stay together in adopting the doctrines we agree on and excuse one another in the doctrines we disagree on. They say, look, if we agree on anything, let's do it. If we disagree, close your eyes. You didn't see me. Let it go. Don't talk to me about it. I don't talk to you about that. Anything that we disagree upon, just turn your face the other side. The Sheikh said this, and they say similar statements that contradict the implications of the Quran verse. There's only one verse. There is many other verses. Like in Surah An-Nisa, verse 59. This is what Allah tells us. See, then they say, let's cooperate on anything we agree on. Anything we agree on, let's do it. If we disagree, we're not going to say, hey, bring Quran and Sunnah. Just let it go. Do your things, I don't mind. That's all Allah said. Whereas Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, if you disagree over anything, because we're human, we're not going to agree on everything, but Allah give us the guidelines. If you disagree over anything, referring to Allah and the messengers. The ulama, they mentioned meaning to the book of Allah and to the sunnah of the messenger of Allah. If you are believers in Allah on the last day, that is the best way and the best result. There is nothing better than that. وقال الشيخ إنه لا اجتماع ولا قوة إلا بالرجوع إلى كتاب الله وسنة رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم وترك ما خالفهما ولا سيما في مسائل العقيدة التي هي الأساس. الشيخ gave this beautiful piece of advice and we conclude with it. He says that the Muslims will never be able to be united and strong. Now we're talking about the unity that is pleasing to Allah SWT. The unity that is legislated for us, not the unity of the bodies and numbers, like Ikhwan and the politicians, they said, oh, no, look, they're united because they have few millions. Now, this is the unity of the hearts upon Tawheed, upon Aqeedah. So the Muslims will never be able to be united and strong enough, except when they have recourse to the Quran and the Sunnah. They have to go back and take their matters to the Book of Allah, to the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah, and leave out what contradicts them. Anything that contradicts the Quran and the Sunnah, we have nothing to do with it. He said, especially in the issues of the greed. Not like you believe in whatever. It's okay. Let the people believe in whatever they want to believe, akhi. And that he wants to believe, that's his problem. No, that's your problem if you know about it. You're an alim now. You're an imam of a masjid. You need to address these matters. Don't say, I don't care. An imam in the masjid itself who give khutbahs and teach, he should, these classes and khutbahs, they should address these problems. Nicely, kindly, of course. He's not going to point out or single out people, but in his khutbah, in his classes, he has to address the mistakes, the bid'ah, the innovations, the mukhalafat in a nice way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا, Surah Al-Imran, verse 103. And hold firmly to the rope of Allah, all of you together, Arabs, non-Arabs, rich and poor, doesn't matter what country of origin you are. Never say, oh, we're from this area, we stick together. People from India and Pakistan stick together. The Africans stick together. The Arabs stick together. People from Kazakhstan, Azerbaijan stick together. People from Bosnia, I don't know what. That's wrong. Muslims, they stick together upon the truth, not upon colors, not upon tribalism. Now, like I told you, if you want to eat some food, your country, go to look for the restaurants of your country, no problem. Like you want to eat some biryani, huh? You go to no Arab restaurant. Go to a Pakistani restaurant and eat some good biryani, inshallah, all right? Right, Maya? Thank you. If you want other food, you want maqlouba, where are you going to go? Hyderabad restaurant? Yeah, you know maqlouba in there. Huh? What is it? Yeah, I get that. You want couscous, you want this, where are you going to go? You go to people, there is nothing wrong with that. But now you want to be upon the right aqidah, where are you going to go? There's no Paki Aqeedah, Hindu Paki Aqeedah, African Aqeedah, Arab Aqeedah, rich Aqeedah. There's no such thing. There's one Aqeedah that all of us, despite the fact that we come from different countries, we speak different dialects, that we have to stick to it. Because Allah tells us, and hold firmly to the rope of Allah all together and do not become divided. ولا يصلح آخر هذه الأمة إلا ما أصلح أولها كما كان يقول إمام مالك. As Imam Malik used to say, nothing whatsoever will rectify the late generations except that which rectified the first part of the generation, Tawheed, Aqeedah, the sound creed. أما قال الشيخ والله الموفق والهادي إلى سوي السبيل وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه. He says, and Allah, it is Allah who grants success and lead us to the right path, and peace be upon our Prophet Muhammad, his household, and his companions. Alhamdulillah, we concluded this introduction, and tomorrow, inshallah, we will go with the second chapter. Barakallahu feekum, jazakumullahu khairan.
وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
We still have 3-4 minutes, inshallah. Who can share with us some of the benefits of this class? One point, inshallah ta'ala. Give us a few points now.
Importance of knowing the right
Aqidah. It is very important for us Muslims to know the proper and the sound creed. It's important. Now. This aqidah should be taken from its proper sources. You don't take aqidah from anybody, from anyone. No, from the proper sources. Quran, sunnah with the understanding of the sahaba. And that's not for me and you. We the specialists, the ulama of the sunnah wal jama'ah.
Calling people to the Prophet and
warning against. Our calls in the masajid, in schools, in our homes. We call people to Tawheed, Muslims. They should be upon Tawheed, and we should warn against shirk, but bil husna ya akhwan, in a nice way, in a kind way. Now, the Aqeedah is for everybody. It's not restricted to one country, one era. Nobody can tell you, oh, that Sheikh is from Saudi, or that's Aqeedah for Saudi. No, it's not. It's not. This Sheikh ain't telling you this is what Saudis are upon. Tell you this is what every Muslim should be upon, regardless where you're from, okay? Now.
If there's any disagreements,
of course, that's true. When disagreement occurs, you're talking to your parents, you're talking to your aunties, a friend, and they tell you, no, it's okay to call upon Jailani, no problem. No. This is what Allah says. Do not call upon others. Call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ahsan, we need to build the foundation, which is the aqidah, the tawheed. Naam, of course, you're going to teach akhlaq, you're going to teach fiqh, seerah, all of this, but you have to make sure these things are built upon the aqidah. Naam. Ahsan. What the unity that we are striving and we ask Allah to unite all the Muslims upon is the unity upon the truth, upon Tawheed, not upon Shirk, not upon unity upon Sunnah, not upon innovation. Now, Ahsan, if a person is upon Shirk, no, Allah is not going to accept nothing because Allah said that in the Quran. لو أشركت ليحبطن عمل. Allah addressed the Prophet the best of the creation. He said to him, if you commit shirk, all your deeds will be void and nullified. In another ayah, Allah says, وَلَوْ أَشْرَقُوا لَحَبِطَ عَنْهُمْ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. If they commit shirk, major shirk, all of their deeds that they used to do, salat, sadaqah, hajj, will be of no benefit. None. Ahsan, the most clear ayat, ya akhwan, in the Quran is the ayat of tawheed.
Barakallahu feekum, jazakumullahu khair, wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
So, Allahu Akbar. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين إن الذين كفروا ينادون لمقت الله أكبر من مقتكم أنفسكم إذ تدعون إلى الإيمان فتكفرون قالوا ربنا أمتنا اثنتين وأحييتنا اثنتين فاعترفنا بذنوبنا فهل إلى خروج من سبيل ذلكم بأنه إذا دعي الله وحده كفرتم وإن يشرك به تؤمنوا فالحكم لله العلي الكبير هو الذي يريكم آياته وينزل لكم من السماء رزقا وما يتذكر إلا من ينيب فادعوا الله مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون رفيع الدرجات ذو العرش يلقي الروح من أمره على من يشاء من عباده لينذر يوم التلاق يوم هم بارزون لا يخفى على الله منهم شيء لمن الملك اليوم لله الواحد القهار الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. اليوم تجزى كل نفس بما كسبت، لا ظلم اليوم، لا ظلم اليوم، اليوم تجزى كل نفس بما كسبت، لا ظلم اليوم، إن الله سريع الحساب. وأنذرهم يوم الآزفة إذ القلوب لدى الحناجر كاظمين، ما للظالمين من حبيب ولا شفيع يطاع، يعلم خائنة الأعين وما تخفي الصدور، والله يقضي بالحق، والذين يدعون من دونه لا يقضون بشيء، إن الله هو السميع البصير. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. استغفر الله. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Brothers and sisters, we are our Sheikh, Noble Sheikh, Sheikh Abu Muhammad al-Maghribi, visiting us from Atlanta. He's going to be here from today all the way to Thursday, inshallah. We have started a new book tonight, Guide to South Creek After Maghrib, every day. Today was the first day, tomorrow, Tuesday and Wednesday, inshallah. Also after Fajr, we have reminders, inshallah, Tuesday, Wednesday and Thursday. And inshallah, tomorrow after Asr, we have a class, special class, advice to the youth. Today after Asr, we had advice to sisters, inshallah. Jazakum Allahu khairan.
Thank you.